Hello friends, in this video we are going to study and verify the truth table of XNOR gate. XNOR gate is the complement of XOR gate. So in my previous video we have seen the implementation of XOR gate. So we will get in this XNOR gate the output which is exactly reverse of your XOR gate, because it is the complement of XOR gate. The symbol that we use to represent XNOR gate is this one, which takes two inputs and there is one output. This bubble indicates NOT gate. So XNOR is the complement of XOR. If you see the first part of this symbol, it is XOR gate, right? And this bubble is NOT gate. So it is the combination of XOR gate and NOT gate. The equation for XNOR gate is Z equals to A into B plus A complement into B complement. It is also represented as A. This is the symbol we use to represent XOR gate. A XNOR B. This is the circuit we can use to obtain this equation. We'll test it on our truth table. For truth table, there are four possibilities of input: 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. We just put these values into the output equation and we'll get the output. If you put 0, 0 here, you'll get this 0 into 0 is 0, first term is 0, 0's complement into 0's complement, that is 1 into 1, so it becomes 1. So final answer is 0 plus 1. So we get it here, it is 1. If you put all the other values of this combination, you will get the output as 0, 0 and 1. Now to verify whether this truth table is correct or not, we are going to use the simulator. There we are going to provide this input to the XNOR gate and we will check whether we get this output or not. So we will open that site. To implement XNOR gate, I am going to use the simulator provided by this website logic.ly/demo. It is very user friendly simulator. On the left hand side you will find input controls, output controls, logic gates, flip flops and others. You just go to the logic gate area and pick the gate that you want to implement. Here we want to implement XNOR gate. So I will drag this XNOR gate. I will pick this and drag it into the working environment here. I want to test only for two inputs, so I will not increase the count here. So keep it as it is and we will try to implement it for two inputs. For two input possibilities, there are four combinations of inputs. So I will take this 0 2 times and 1 2 times so that we can obtain all the four possibilities from these combinations. On the right hand side, towards the output side, we place the bulb, that is lamp. If lamp glows after applying the inputs, then your result is 1, otherwise the result is 0. So our circuit is ready, we just have to connect the wires. Now our first input is 0, 0. For the XNOR gate, just connect the first input from here to here. 0, 0 combinations we apply and we want to check the output on the lamp. Just connect it to the lamp and the lamp is glowing. Whenever the input is 0, 0 in XNOR gate, the output is 1. We will check the output for the second input possibility, that is 0, 1. So I will remove the second wire and I will connect this 1 to this gate. And I will check the output on the right hand side. If you see the right hand side, the lamp is not glowing. That's why the output is 0 for this input possibility. So for 0 and 1 as input to the XNOR gate, your output is 0. And same for 1, 0. You just change the input possibilities to 1, 0. Your output is again 0. So I'll now check the output for the last input possibility, that is 1, 1. I'll make both the inputs as 1. So I'll first connect this wire to the first input, this one to the second input, and I'll check on the right hand side whether the lamp glows or not. The lamp is glowing, that's why our output is 1. So whenever there is 1-1 as the input to the NOR gate, your output of NOR gate is 1. Now if you observed here, all the outputs are exactly reverse of the output of the XOR gate. That's why we can say that XNOR gate is the complement of XNOR gate, or XNOR gate is the complement of XOR gate, vice versa. Both are true. Thank you very much for watching this video.